Hello friends, my name is Nilesh. Welcome to my channel. In this video, we are going to see how we can use two of the tools in Kubernetes to use or to improve your productivity. Let's put it in a problem statement. You might be a person who is working constantly with different set of Kubernetes clusters and you have multiple contexts. Maybe you have different environments and every environment has multiple workloads running on it. And you need to switch constantly between your different namespaces or different contexts that you use to connect to the Kubernetes cluster. So let me switch to a demo and show you what I have as a setup and what we can do to improve the productivity while working with multiple Kubernetes clusters. So if you look at my screen, I have two Kubernetes clusters here. One is named the monitoring cluster, and the other one is named MSDactor Live Demo Cluster. And both this, they have different workloads running in them. So let's start by listing down all the contexts that I have currently in my kubeconfig. So I have two contexts here. The first one is monitoring cluster, and the second one is MSDactor cluster. And my current context is pointing to the second, the MSDactor Live Demo. So let's run one of the command to see what are the nodes here. If I run kubectl get nodes, we see all the nodes related to this cluster. We see that there are three nodes and they were created about 2 hours back. Now I want to switch the context to the other cluster, which is the monitoring cluster. This I can do using kubectl config, and if I run the config help command, it will give me all the options which are available as part of kubectl config, and I can use one of the subcommands here to set the current context. So my current context is pointing to the second cluster that I have. I want to switch the context to the first. So I can use the set context here to set the context to the other cluster. So I can say kubectl config, then set context, and then the name of the context. So it is named as monitoring cluster. And there is a spelling mistake here. Let me correct the typo. Kubectl and now the monitoring cluster has been, the context has been created. Sorry, there is again a typo here. Let me correct that. So this way I can switch the context, but it can be very time consuming. You can see that there could be typos, I can misspell, I might not remember the name of the whole cluster context. Would it not be easier if I had a tool which can do it automatically for me? And that is the topic of today's session. I'll be covering two utility tools or to add-on sort of things which enable us to switch the context very easily when it comes to switching context for a Kubernetes cluster where you are working with multiple clusters. So without any further ado, let me switch to the two tools that I'm going to introduce. Let me first clear the screen here. The first one is called kubectl or kubectx. So the way this works is I can install this and I can run a command called kubectx, which will give me all the contexts that I have currently in my kubeconfig. So because I made that typo, you can see that I have three contexts here, but actually there are only two. Let me delete the one which is having a spelling mistake. So I can say kubectx. Let me first copy that. It is one drawing cluster, so cube ctx fmt, and I can say one drawing cluster. Choose any option. Okay, no problem. Let me first go back, clear the screen, and run the same command again. Kubectx delete for hyphen d, and then the cluster that I want to, or context I want to delete, monitoring cluster is the cluster name or context name with the typo. Now if I do kubectx, it will show me what are the contexts that I have currently configured. So there is a monitoring cluster and there is MS Reactor live demo cluster. I can switch between these two by using the up and down arrow key. And there is also a nice feature here where I can use a fuzzy search. This again depends on another add-on, which I'll talk a little bit later. But if I want to just switch to, let's say, MS Reactor and the live one, I can then use this one, and once I select this, it will switch the context to the MS Reactor live demo cluster. And here, if I run the same command for getting the nodes now, kubectl get nodes, it will show me the nodes which are part of this cluster, again created about 2 hours ago. Now let me switch the context to the other cluster that I have, the monitoring cluster, kubectx, and I'm switching it to the monitoring cluster now. You can see how quickly it switches the context to the monitoring cluster. And if I run the same command now, kubectl get nodes, I should get the nodes from the second cluster. So this, you can see here that this cluster was created about 8 hours ago, and the three nodes related to this are having a different name. I can also run kubectl get pods and see what are the workloads running here. So right now it is showing only two pods, because if you look at my prompt here, it shows I'm pointing to the monitoring cluster and the namespace is pointing to KEDA. If I point to the default namespace, let me just change the namespace, and that is where I'm going to use the other productivity tool or the utility, which is called as KubeNS, which stands for the namespace part, Kube namespace. And here it will list down all the namespaces which are available on this cluster. So my current namespace, which is shown in green color here, is the KEDA one, and I want to switch to the default namespace. So I can again use up and down arrow key and select default. Now my active namespace is pointing to default, and if I run the kubectl get pods command here, I should see all the pods running under the default namespace. Again, a typo there, kubectl get pods. And you can see there are about 6 different pods running under the default namespace. Now let me switch to the other cluster again, and let's see what are the pods running there. Kubectx here to switch. The way I can switch again is I can go through this kubectx command and I can choose one of these clusters, or I can just say kubectx minus. In this case, it will take me to the previous context, or the context would be switched to the one which was active, or the default, the selected one before my current context. And in this case, you can say since I had only two contexts, it switched back to the MS Reactor live demo cluster context. Now, if I run the kubectl get pods on this cluster, sorry about that, again the typo, kubectl get pods, In one of the future videos, again, I will show you how to improve the productivity when it comes to the kubectl commands itself. That's a topic for another video. So in this case, we can see that in the default namespace, there are only three pins. So this way, it helps us to switch between both the context of the cluster that we are pointing to as well as the namespace. How do we get these two utilities? Let me take you to the GitHub repo where these utilities are available. These are part of the Ahmed, okay, there is a person, Ahmed Balkan, who is a software engineer at Google, and he has created these two utilities, kubectl or context and the kubens. These are named as the power tools for kubectl, and you can find instructions about how to install them here. If you are on Mac or if you are on Unix system, you can use the package managers like Homebrew for installing on Mac. I'm on Windows, so I'm using Chocolaty here in this case. So if you know Chocolaty, it's a package manager for Windows, and Chocolaty has the packages for deploying or installing both kubectl as well as kubens. I've already installed them, but let me show you how you can search for it. So we can fire these commands, choco search, and search for kubectl package. And you will find in the results that this is available as kubectl-ps. There is also, similarly, we can search for a kubens package. Kubens. And you can see that there are two different versions, one which is part of the kubectl, the other one is standalone kubens 0.9.3. And then we can install this. So for installing, we can use choco install and then the name of the package. So it will be kubectl, or in case of kubens, it will be choco install kubens. Now, to enable the interactive mode, we need the fuzzy search enabled. That is also available as another package, which we can search on the Chocolaty package manager, again using choco search fzf fuzzy search. And this is also available on, sorry about the typo again, on Homebrew as well. So we can install the fuzzy search using Homebrew as well if you are on Mac. So we see there is 0.27.2 version of fzf. So because of this fzf, when we do the kubectl, we get that interactive options. We can go up and down, or we can also do fuzzy search. Like if I just type live here, it will select only the cluster which has, or the context which has live in that, and then just press enter to switch the context. Now there are a couple of other things available as part of kubectl. So like most of the command line tools, we can use the help menu to find out what are the options available. Kubectl-h will give us the different parameters or different subcommands that are available as part of kubectl. So you can see here, if we just type kubectl, it will list all the context available. We can switch the context by giving the name directly. The previous context I already showed you by typing kubectl- or kubectl-. We can also find out what is the current context. My PowerShell prompt here shows what is the current context, as well as if I have selected a specific namespace, it will also show the namespace. But if you don't have a prompt which shows you what is the current context and you want to find out where are you currently, then you can do this kubectl-c or -c or if you prefer the full version, extended version of that, you can also say --current, and that will show us what is the current text we are pointing to. And we can also unset the context. We can give a name if we want to give a friendly name. Let's say you have a big name like MS Reactor Live Demo Cluster here, and if I want to use an alias kind of thing, then I can use a new name feature. And delete, I already showed you when I created a cluster with the context, with the typo, and using -d, I was able to delete that. Same way when it comes to cube NS as well, we have the same options. Using the help, I can find out what are the different options available with kubeNS utility. The options are limited here because the namespaces, there are very little things that you can do with the namespace. You have the options to list all the namespaces. You can switch to a specific namespace using the second name option. We can switch back to the previous one. We can also see what is the current one. So let's try this. Let's first clear the screen. kubeNS. If I do minus, it should switch back to the previous, but in this current context, I don't have any previous namespace selected as my current namespace. So let me first select a namespace and switch a namespace as well to make it work. So let's first list down all the namespaces in this cluster. So we have default KEDA, kube node lease, kube public, and kube system. So let me switch to the KEDA namespace and just list all the services in the KEDA namespace. So kubectl get svc for service. And there is one service under the KEDA namespace which is listed here. This is what I was saying about my prompt, that it shows the current context that I am pointing to as well as the namespace, which is KEDA in this case. Now let me switch to the default namespace using kubeNS minus. So this should take me back to the default namespace. So you can see that it is quite easy and quite convenient to work with these two utilities, especially in an environment where you have multiple clusters, multiple contexts, and you have to keep switching between the context as well as the namespaces. This can improve your productivity quite a bit. I hope you found this useful. In the future part of these tips and tricks, I will also show, as I said, some of the utilities or some of the tools I use for improving my productivity when it comes to working with kubectl itself. And that's for the next demo or next video. I hope you found this useful. If you found this video useful, please hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, and also help to spread the word with your friends. Thank you. Thanks for watching this video.